Hello viewers, my name is Apostle Henry Rudokin, coming to you on the waves of Majesty Christian Television Network. We are here this evening with migrant leaders or migrant community to discuss on healthy lifestyle. Our topic tonight is the migrants community's perspective on pursuing a healthy lifestyle. As we all know, in this forum, this community will be giving their perspective on the issues pertaining to a healthy lifestyle. We all know that this has been the topic for this season. So everybody just want to know what healthy lifestyle is all about and also to pursue it. So the migrant community here are not left behind. So permit me this hour to introduce you to all our guests who are here. So I start with the ladies who are seated with me. Please introduce yourself.
Yeah, my name is Rejoice Doche.
Okay, welcome to Majesty TV.
Thank you.
Yes. Chani?
Hi, my name is Chani Barzanai. I'm a dietitian also here in South Oost, and I also come to talk today about healthy nutrition and healthy lifestyle.
Thank you for coming. You're welcome. Yeselda?
Yeah, Ameda Uyi Olaye, the National Vice President of Nigerian National Association in the Netherlands, and I'm a journalist and a counselor. Thank you for having me.
Thank you so much, Elder. Thank you for coming. Right. You speak, please.
My name is Innocent Namoasa.
Yes, speak through it. It's on already.
My name is Innocent Namoasen. I'm from Treasures International Ministry, a nurse by profession, and it is a privilege to be here this evening.
Thank you for being with us.
Good evening. My name is Pearl Ahiable. I'm from JC and International Ministry, and I've come this evening also to talk on how to have a healthy lifestyle.
Thank you, Pearl, for being with us. Thank you so much.
My name is Rod Irene. I am the president of a doing union in the Netherlands.
Yes.
I am a community leader.
Yeah.
A writer, a father, a grandfather, and all put together.
Thank you, Bishop, for being with us. Okay, I just hope the microphone will be a little bit high so that their voices can be picked up properly. Well, welcome to Majesty Christian Television Network once again, and we want you to feel relaxed and give your own perspective towards healthy lifestyle spontaneously. That means I'm not going to be saying you, so just, you know, speak spontaneously as you are led. Now, the first question which I want us to tackle right now is, do you really know what, when we talk about healthy lifestyle, what does that mean to you? Do you really know what healthy lifestyle is all about? Yes.
From my perspective, I think it connotes the ability for you to know what to do to have a very maintain a very healthy lifestyle.
Bishop, can you put your microphone?
Okay. I think from my perspective, it means for you to know what to do in terms of physical activity and also what you eat,
mm-hmm.
For you to have a very healthy lifestyle.
Okay, you said it's physical activity.
Physical and in terms of your eating habit, what you put into you. Like they said, a healthy life is a healthy life.
Okay, thank you, sir. All right, somebody else, please, can you add to what Bishop has just said?
Yes, to have a healthy lifestyle, it is not indeed not only what you eat, but also the determination to have your life put all together. Also the physical aspect, as Rodney, as Bishop has spoken about. And also I think that we should be aware of what a healthy lifestyle should be. Not only we think of it or getting in the way of losing weight,
mm-hmm.
but also really be aware of what it is, that there is an effort that we all have to put into it to have and keep our lifestyle healthy.
Thank you so much, Belle. Somebody else, please. Just tell us from your own perspective what you know about healthy lifestyle.
A healthy lifestyle to me, it is a state of physical, mental, and social well-being, being physically fit, mentally fit, and socially related good to other people. That is a healthy lifestyle to me.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yeah. Well, I would see a healthy lifestyle from different perspectives, in the sense that when we're talking about something healthy,
yeah,
we are talking about something that is sane without infirmities.
Okay.
Right? And so we look at it from different perspectives. We can be spiritually healthy.
Yeah.
We can be physically healthy.
Mm-hmm.
We can be mentally or psychologically healthy.
Mm-hmm.
So it depends on each of these ones are wide topics that we cannot finish on this program.
Mm.
But I want to look at it from a particular angle,
okay,
the physical and the social perspectives.
Okay.
A healthy lifestyle is the one that has to do with we are deliberately living on a daily basis in a way that will not harm our health, that will not damage our health.
Hmm. Okay.
Socially, we need to be able to determine our social lifestyle, you know, the kind of things we do from day to day, the kind of things we expose ourselves to, and the kind of our social life that we live, like the drinking habit,
okay,
eating habit,
okay,
and also we need to be able to consider what is good for our health. Obviously, what may be good for Bishop if he consumes it may not be good for my own metabolism.
Okay,
so we need to be able to consider living a healthy lifestyle has to do with our social life, our feeding habit, and our mental attitude to life.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Elder. And let me hear from Sister Joyce before the professional. No, it's okay. Use that one. Use this one.
Yeah.
Just speak.
How I understand a healthy lifestyle is how do you manage your life or yourself? As the others said, both physical, spiritual, and what we take in and how we associate ourselves with people.
Mm-hmm.
Because there are a lot of things that are happening now. If you don't focus well on yourself, all the time you'll be depressed. And depression brings a lot of things that are not worth to be in us.
Okay. So in a nutshell, we have touched the physical and we have touched the social aspect, and we've also touched the emotional aspect of healthy lifestyle, probably as well some touch the spiritual aspect. These are the things that comprises of a healthy lifestyle. Now we ask the professional, the dietitian, from the definition we've just given, can you assess this to be the complete definition of healthy lifestyle?
Yeah, because I totally agree with everybody said, because it's what we actually had the privilege to talk with you about before.
Yeah.
And we talked about it was not only it's not only about your physical, but what actually everybody mentioned, emotionally, socially, and physically.
Yeah.
And what it's all about, it's like the quality of your life,
mm-hmm,
not just from now, but also for the long term. How do I want the choices that I make and how I choose to live my life?
Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you so much. Then the second question is, are you all aware of the healthy trend which is playing out among the migrant community? Because research have proved that the migrant community, most of them from the sub-Saharan Africa region, they are having overweight, and they are having sicknesses like diabetes blood pressure, high blood pressure. Are you all aware of this? Yes.
Yes, we are aware. We are migrants in Europe, and we've been here for many of us have been here for a decade or more.
Yeah.
And obviously, we know that we have been affected. You know, even environmentally, we have been affected by the health environment that is available in Europe, which naturally sometimes we feel we are not made for this environment.
Really?
Okay.
Okay.
Because the environment affects us so badly that we try to cope in a very difficult way. And obviously, if you compare the, because we came from a tropical region.
Yeah.
Very, very hot.
Yeah.
What I tell people, I say, I come from a place where you have summer, 12 months of the year.
Yeah.
Okay. And but here, I'm forced to live on a cold environment for six, seven months in a year.
Yeah.
And so you don't expect, because I was already an adult before I left my country. Okay. So, to expect me to be able to adjust physically and metabolically to this cold situation, it's not easy, and I know it's affecting my health.
Okay.
Yes.
Thank you so much. Yes. Somebody else? Yes. Spontaneously.
It is said, it's a garbage in, garbage out. And our people are holding on to certain dogmas that they refuse to let go.
Okay.
That is, my father lived 100 years. He was eating padded yam to go to bed. Why are you preventing me from eating padded yam? And they said, my people suffer for lack of knowledge.
Yes.
There is a deficit of knowledge. People refuse to learn and understand that your father is different from who you are.
Yeah.
You don't carry 100% DNA of your father. It's not possible.
Mm-hmm.
Because you came from a different woman. Your father came from a different woman. So obviously, and people wholly refuse to understand that, look, our fathers lived in Africa. They ate food that were grown 100% without no fertilizers.
Yeah.
My father was not breathing in air that is polluted by fossil fuel. The village I grew up somewhere in Edo State in Nigeria, in Africa, you can hardly see a car when I was a little boy. We used to play on the main road. But these days, cars are everywhere.
Yeah.
They burn fossil fuel. They pollute the environment. We inhale what they take out from their exhaust. And this begins to affect our health. In addition, my father used to go to the farm, harvest crop, bring them home. They are cooked fresh.
Yes.
Eat them that evening. And the next day, my mother cook. We never use refrigerators. There were no refrigerators when I was a little child back home.
Yes.
And everything was eating fresh 100%. So if you put all this together and you now just oppose it with what we have today. When I cook food here in Holland, somebody, I have to refrigerate it.
Yes.
It's frozen, like in the Antarctic. I bring it out, put it in a microwave, heat it up, bring it out in plastics. All this has adverse effect on us. So we must be able to get knowledge. And when we get knowledge, we should be able to overcome some of the health challenges. Black people are susceptible to high blood pressure. And most of these things are genetics. Diabetes, high blood pressure, our attitude to life. I research to find out that HIV is a killer in Africa. Why? Because people understand, but they refuse to acknowledge the fact that when you have a protected sex, you will die.
Yes.
So there are so many things to talk about. The bottom line remains, it is important our people should get an education and understand that what we are living now is not the life our father lives. The life we are living now is not the life my children and our grandchildren will live. Learn to live in the moment, follow the flow, and be educated.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you. That's a very solid point.
Yes.
Wow.
Yes.
Wow. I think the dietitian is nodding her head.
Yeah.
You love it.
Yeah.
Yes.
I'm totally agree. And also on a professional perspective, I'm totally agreeing with you.
Yeah,
because the environment we're living in nowadays is so different, but it's also important to acknowledge that we still have our culture, and we live in a different country.
Right.
But we want to keep the culture, but to adjust to the Dutch environment that we're having here.
We must be able to keep the positive part of our culture.
Exactly.
Like I've often told people, listen, there is no ideal society.
Yes.
You can never have an ideal world until it depends on your faith. If you believe there is heaven, I'm a Christian, I profess to Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior, and I believe if I live a healthy life and I die, I go to heaven. That is my personal belief. But that is when you have an ideal world, or if there is a world over there. As far as we are on planet Earth and we are human, we can never have an ideal society. What I've often tried to teach people is that, look, Africa is rich in tradition, and the Dutch culture have where they are good. Let us begin to take what is good in Africa, joining with what is good in Europe, I will have a semblance, in quote, of an ideal society. This is what I have preached, and that is why I have very few friends, because when you speak the truth, most people don't want to hear the truth.
Yeah. All right.
I will stand on the truth till I drop dead.
Thank you, thank you, thank you, sir. So, yes, you can continue.
I just want to add up, in this case, is that the discipline mentality, that is what we need to adapt to. And that is one of the things also that, as we are here in Holland, the Holland people is like, just do it.
Mm.
We go to work, we have to take care of our children, we have education. But maybe it's in Africa, our mentality is that everything is, we have all the time of the world to do whatever we want. Mm. But here you have a limited time, and you have to make the best use out of it. And for us to be able to come up is that to encourage each other, that as my brother next to me is saying, we have to embrace what we have, the good part that we are seeing here. We have to embrace it and add up our what we also have learned from Africa, our mentality. I would say that I have a child, he's like 4 months now, and everywhere I hear that breastfeeding is the best of the best. This is the thing that we do in Africa.
Mm-hmm.
We breastfeed our children, we take care of them, we hold them. Even nowadays, you can see in the shops that they use, like normally we carry the babies on our back.
Mm.
But now they have these special things that we can carry the baby on
in
our
front.
Back and
yes.
in the front also,
yeah. yes.
both front and back.
Yeah.
And do you know that they also have this material? Just like our African cloth, how we hold the baby up in our back. They also have, they teach you in the shop how to bundle the baby on your back and everything. I look at the lady, I said, listen, I have my cloth at home and I can carry my baby on my back. So thank you very much. This is an African way. And you have to pay like 80 euro for that. You know, so shortly what I'm saying is that what we have in Africa, education system we have in Africa, and what we know, it is not all lost. It is not a bad. It's a very, very good thing. But we need to be bold and bring it out to teach our fellow men also here abroad.
Thank you so much. I would like the nurse to contribute to this because she's a professional nurse. And I believe that you've been seeing our people coming to the hospitals and then with some of these diseases. How does that make you feel? Is it that they are ignorant or information is not reaching them? Or it's just a way of life, just like we heard from some of our panelists who said the culture is playing out here. So I know that this some of these heavy diseases can be genetic, though, but it's not really disease because they call it a way of life.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Okay? We call it disease, but it's not really disease because it's a lifestyle disease, which can be, it's called lifestyle disease because it can be avoided.
Yeah.
It can be avoided. So tell us your experience as a nurse and how do you see our people who normally come?
First of all, I believe that all food is good. And in all foods, we have some nutrients that we need. Foods from Africa, foods from here. But there must be a balance in everything.
Mm-hmm.
We have to balance our lives in on what we eat.
Mm-hmm.
We have to know what we take in. For example, I chose, if I want to eat fufu, I eat it once or twice every 2 weeks, at least once a week, so I can still hold on to my culture. Or if I want to eat rice, there are some certain rice you eat that it has low calories. But the thing is that just as they all say, this is a culture thing.
Mm-hmm.
Right away from home, we were raised like this. This is all that we knew. When I came to Europe, I was bigger because I thought in my country, the bigger you are, the more healthier you are.
Yeah.
That is how they look at things. So when I go home, even with this size, they're like, girl, are you not eating? You need to eat more food. And I'm like, I need to lose weight, you know? So it is a culture thing. People know exactly what to do. They know that what they are eating is not good for them. They know that if you exercise a little bit, even in your busy schedules, I'm so busy, I'm a mother, I'm a student, church activities, but at least I try even though twice a week to go to the gym and work out. It's good for your mind also, it erases stress, so mentally you become well, physically you become well. So I think it is balancing all areas of your life, to find a balance in everything that you do. All foods are good, mm-hmm. but if you know how to balance them well, mm-hmm. you know, I train twice a week in the gym, mm-hmm. and mentally prayers are very good. Mm-hmm. I meditate on the word of God. Mm-hmm. I go to church services. Mm-hmm. So I would say it is a balance of all things.
Mm-hmm. Thank you so much. Yes.
If I may need to add to what my co-panelists are saying, mm-hmm. you see, I think we have a problem somewhere.
Okay.
We from Africa, particularly when I talk about my people from Nigeria, mm-hmm. I relate with them almost on a daily basis. I'm a leader in an association here, and yeah. we relate with ourselves as Nigerians, and we talk about issues of common interest.
Yeah.
You see, I said we have a problem because it will be difficult to convince a true Nigerian man to not to eat the way we started eating in Africa. Ate in Africa.
That's the problem.
For example,
hit it. Come on.
You see, like Bishop said earlier, you tell a Nigerian man, a real Nigerian man,
yes,
to say, don't eat pounded yam in the evening after he went to work in the morning and he came, he's so hungry.
Yeah, it's true.
If the wife gives him rice, he's going to be angry.
Oh,
my friend, what is this? I need pardon here. I need something heavy.
And you see, very late in the night.
To gain back my energy.
Yes.
If I don't eat heavy food, then I will not have enough energy. I will not have enough strength to walk. I will not, you know, we believe that what we eat makes us, eating heavy food makes us more healthy.
Mm.
That's our belief.
It's, yes, yeah. exactly. Okay? It's true.
And it is difficult to erase that, to remove it that
is.
Belief from here.
It is.
Okay, we are all included.
Yeah.
Sometimes,
it's true.
My wife gives me
salad in the evening.
Salad uh-huh. on ripe plantain with a sauce,
yes.
tomato sauce.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'll say, madam, please, you want me to fall on the street?
Yes.
This thing is not good for me. She will say it's good. Honey is good. It's calcium.
Yeah.
This is. I'll say, I don't need calcium. I need energy. Okay. And so the other time I went to my doctor.
Yes.
And the doctor told me, when my wife presented this to me, that has vitamins that replaces my lost nutrients and all in my body. I don't want to eat them because that is not what I want. I'm an African.
Yeah.
Okay. The other time I went to the doctor recently, the doctor told me, look, Elder, you lack vitamins.
Because they are just eating what you want.
He told me that, look, Elder, you are not healthy.
Yes.
You are not healthy. You lack vitamins. You lack this. You lack that. Yeah. I said, stop. Don't make me my high blood pressure to go up, because it's like you are telling me that I'm dying tomorrow if I like all these things. You see, it's our habit.
A habit.
And you see, if we are in Africa, it's different because we have the hot weather that makes us to sweat.
That melts it,
even
yes.
without doing anything, you see that you are sweating.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay? Mm-hmm. And it sweats out these extra calories.
Yes,
on his own.
Yeah.
Okay? But here, they don't sweat out.
At all.
We eat them and they stay in our body. Sometimes I wake up, I have body pain.
It's terrible.
Without doing anything.
And the worst part, mm-hmm. to add to what you are saying, Elder, is that they finish eating this heavy stuff. Instead of them maybe to drink hot water or drink tea, they go and add it up with wine. Some of them add it up with stout or Coca-Cola. You know, they add those things because if you don't drink the Coca-Cola or Fanta, it's like they've not started.
Yes.
So these are some of the things that are piling up sugar in us and then making us to have all of these heavy sicknesses. Let me allow you to speak. Yes.
And one part too is most of the time, as you said, before we eat, the mistake we also do a lot is before we eat, we feel that we don't have enough appetite, so we have to take in some akpeteshi or some wine.
What is that?
Hot drink, okay. Hot drink.
You think so?
Yeah, it happens. Yeah, we do eat a lot.
Yeah.
So they drink appetizer. Yeah. So we take the akpeteshi. So the fufu, if maybe you have to eat just a small bowl like this, you have to eat about one full bowl before you are okay. Yeah. Then you get more appetite, so you'll be eating. You'll be eating and eating and eating and eating. You know, before you know, you have overfed yourself.
Oh,
so,
my
and
God.
From there, we don't go to work or anything like that. So
yeah.
From there, you sit down, already you are feeling sleepy.
Yeah.
So you just relax in the chair, you doze off, you wake up, then you go to bed.
It's terrible.
Yeah.
It's terrible.
You know,
yes, what do you have to say, honey?
Well, I have an interesting point because I'm totally agreeing with you. It's like a habit. Whatever what you said, it's a habit.
Yeah.
It's a habit that you grew up with. It's cultural. But a point I want to make, and actually also to ask you, like something that I really like to talk about.
Yeah.
It's a matter of, like, it's a habit that we're having, but how can we change it?
Yes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
How can we change it? It's a matter of trust.
Yes.
And trust the professionals.
Yeah.
Sometimes what I experience is, like, how can we, with a different culture, can trust the professionals that lives in Holland,
mm-hmm.
and to want to give you information, something that's different than your own culture.
Let me come up here. The fact is that we are even ignorant of knowing who is a professional.
Yeah.
Because you can't go and tell the African man you need a professional. For what?
Yeah.
Because he has not yet fallen sick, you know?
Yeah.
They don't even get the information.
Yeah.
They don't even. So if you go about telling them you need professional, then the first thing is, professional for what? Did I tell you I'm sick?
Mm-hmm.
So that's the trust
you see?
That we're
and
having.
And secondly, let me come in here. Secondly, the professionals themselves, like you, they are not making any effort to get to the people. You know, I feel so embarrassed that this thing has come to its peak before the city council can begin to carry out a campaign about this unhealthy lifestyle.
Mm-hmm.
Why didn't the EU? Because if I would just challenge only city council, I would be just undermining the whole thing, making an understatement. Because this healthy lifestyle we are talking about is something that is playing out now in the EU level, okay? So why didn't they find all of these things before? Until it has piled up and then the ratio has gone so high before they are coming out now and telling us healthy lifestyle, healthy lifestyle. Do you understand?
Yeah.
If it would take all of this number of years for EU to come up with this, then how about Africa? Because Africa, we already have the mentality that the more big we look, the healthier we are.
Yeah.
Recently, I saw somebody who traveled to Africa and just came back. As a matter of fact, I nearly collapsed because when he went to Africa just for these few months, he was looking a little bit trendy, but he came back, and now his stomach is as big as I was. I was just looking, I said, wow, this is too much. Is it? I nearly asked him, please, are you healthy? Because I was afraid because I was only making like this. I only put my like, Oh! Well, because I want to scream because I didn't know this person to be this way.
Yeah.
So I really don't know what the person went to eat in Africa for just within 2.5 months, and that can swell that person to that level. Do you understand? So you guys are not making your campaign. You're not doing anything until they have to come and bring you out to say, tell us. So we think it would be nice that you, the professionals, so-called professionals, unquote, you have to do everything to carry out the campaign, reach out to the masses wherever they are, tell them about healthy lifestyle, tell them what they are eating which is not right, and then help to contribute to them becoming better. Do you understand what I mean?
I understand that. I'm totally agreeing. That's why I cannot talk for the other professionals.
Yeah.
But I'm just talking now for myself. Like, when I'm here, I'm talking to you, and I'm open as a professional also to learn. That's why I ask you what, because I know it's a big problem, because when somebody come to me, when I talk, there will be a trust. There will be, we talk and then we on the same level. But I know for a lot of people of the African community, it's like a little, a big trust issue to come to even see me. So I know when somebody makes the effort to see me, I have to respect him too, because I know there is a cultural differences, and I know he made already the big effort to come to see me. But that's why I want to make awareness and ask you, like, what of your perspective, what from the African perspective, what would you like from the professional as a trust to go without being forced into it, but to be more open to it from the community itself?
I think it's education.
I
think it's education first. Like I have stated before, education is important. When you lack education, you become ignorant.
Yeah.
People begin to forget how creation started. After Adam and Eve to blah, blah, blah. Listen, God did not create the beef, the meat we eat, antelope, elephant, and tie them in one place. Mm-hmm. So our people were gatherers. They pursue the animals in the bush. And in that process of catching an animal, they have burned so many calories.
That's what we talked about.
Listen, in addition, we go to farm. We never have farms in greenhouses. So from where I was born, we trek almost more than 5 to 10 kilometers before we get to farm. That is enough exercise. And we use equipment to till the ground, no caterpillars. That was enough exercise. Now, you see, that is where the ignorance come in. That you were brought up in this type of environment, that every day you were doing exercise naturally by going to farm. To fetch water, there was no tap water at home. You have to go to the stream. It takes you 5 to 10 kilometers to fetch kilos of water and put it on your head. By the time you come back, you have sweated and burned some fats. Now we find ourselves in this part of the world. What do we do? So what we do is, just last week, I visited XY. And he lives on the 8th floor. He's far younger than me. When we come to the ground floor, he pressed the lift. I say, why? He said, let's go up. I said, no, let's take the staircase. Mm-hmm. He said, no, I can't do it. I said, look, I'm far older than you. Mm-hmm. Let's take the lift. I live in an apartment building. I'm on the 7th floor to be precise.
Yeah.
I can tell you that in a year, I can count how many times I take the elevator.
Yeah.
I rather take the steps.
Yeah. Yeah.
These are the little things we should do. Mm-hmm. When you leave your house, maybe you have a car, you jump into your car, you drive to work, you go to your office, an air-conditioned place or whatever, you close, you jump into your car, you it's come home, low. You have not sweated. Your heart is still at the same level. Mm. It has not pumped. So all these things begin to build, is it fat in your arteries? Yes. And before you know it, you get a heart attack. And you know what they're going to do? As African, they say, I want witch for village.
Yeah.
This is dogmatic beliefs that are not correct. Somebody have killed him. In Africa, even a 90-year-old man will die, they say, somebody killed him. Yeah. There are certain things we must learn to do away with. That is why I said, let us pick the best part of Africa. Magic with the best part of Europe, we will have a semblance of an ideal society.
But let me come in, Chief Rodney. This thing we are talking about, going to farm or trekking maybe 10 kilos and whatever, I think it happened in the past, not now. Yeah. Well, not now, because not everybody.
You can't replicate. You can't
trekking that way, because we also have some gardens at the back of our homes where you grow the food you eat as well, you know. But if the farm you are talking about is still in existence, this same diseases we are talking about is too high also in Africa. So it's not only here. Many of the people are dying of high blood pressure. Many are dying of diabetes. Be ignorant about it, because they don't even know that a diabetic distance can be a little bit avoided. They don't even know, okay?
That's why you said to the knowledge.
Education.
But it's important to know where the education has come from. That's why I think, for me, it's special to come here today.
Yeah.
As a professional, to know, like, all your religious speakers, that you educate the people. And I think that's very important, that we learn to work together.
Exactly.
And I really appreciate to be here and to see, like, everything you say. I'm so on the same level with everybody and what you say. So I'm so blessed to be here and to hear and see what you're actually saying, and so agreeing with it. So
yes.
For me, it's a blessing.
And to add up, not only to hear, you have to add up where we are making mistakes. Because you don't just go about believing everything we say. Because may not be the correct thing. So don't be intimidated. Tell them the truth.
Yeah, but that's what I said. Everything I heard about education and about, that's where we started. That's the basics. Like how, when we start with ourselves.
Yeah.
And then when we know where the information comes from. Mm-hmm. Because sometimes it can be like a little bit, like at home, I learned that, like, how bigger I am, the wealthier and better it is. But now I come here, and they say, like, the bigger you are, more risk of health issues. Mm-hmm. So I can understand that it's like, my basics and my new basics, like how can I cooperate and what's true. So that's what we learn about, and now we start to learn, the new generation starts to learn from you as the leaders, that like the knowledge that we're having nowadays, why? So what's the source of the knowledge we're having? What's the source of the information?
I agree with everything we are saying, but I think we are tackling the physical aspect more.
Mm-hmm.
Let us not forget that the mental aspect is also
mental.
There.
Yeah,
and it
true.
Is playing a very big role
mm-hmm.
in the society.
Mm-hmm.
A lot
true.
Of our African brothers and sisters, they are depressed, they
yes.
are stressed.
Yeah.
Just imagine people who are walking around without documents, people who are walking around back home, they sold everything they had to buy a ticket for you to fly
Speak.
Abroad.
Yes.
You came here, you think all things will go well.
Hey.
And because of your mental disorder
yeah.
at the moment, you're emotionally not in balance,
mm-hmm.
you know. Sometimes we also have emotional eaters, for example.
Mm-hmm.
They know exactly what to do. They know that eating healthy is good, exercising is good, but because of the situation they have found themselves in the diaspora,
yeah.
they find it difficult,
mm.
and their mind is only telling them, eat, 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 eat. So I think
yeah,
also
correct.
It is not only the
yes.
physical,
yeah.
but
the
also
mental.
The mental aspect.
Exactly.
We have also to look at it.
Wow, yeah. awesome. Yeah, Pearl, can you say something?
My sister has said it all, because it is true that not only the physical, but also your mental aspect. And I also will add up that your spiritual aspect is also very, very important.
Mm-hmm.
In that case, that as you meditate on the word of God,
mm-hmm.
it's also help you to see things in perspective,
mm-hmm.
and also how to take charge of your own life,
mm-hmm.
because it is the ownership of making a better life,
mm-hmm.
because you can look at somebody that has a good life,
mm-hmm.
but that doesn't it doesn't mean that you cannot, because
mm-hmm.
most of us, we see it and we say, oh, it is too hard for us to achieve such a lifestyle,
mm-hmm.
but you just start where you are, small as it is, you know, start to organize yourself.
Yeah.
It's just like the little thing. Do not isolate yourself from other people, but try to also get into have a relationship with people.
Yeah.
Ask what you do not know, and don't be afraid to ask questions about how to eat better or how to associate with others better, because we isolate ourselves and we sometimes also don't want to get involved with other cultures.
Yeah.
But it does help us a lot.
Exactly.
To just have that relationship get it all together.
Yes, if I would need to also contribute something here. You see, like I said earlier, immigrants.
Yeah.
I may not be able to talk for all immigrants, because I don't know too much about other people from other, maybe South America and all that. But I know we have similar culture, similar environment.
Yeah.
I want to emphasize that we, like I said earlier, we have a particular problem. And this problem,
we
Africans.
Okay.
Okay. And that problem is a belief problem. It's a problem of belief.
Okay.
It's very, very, it's like religion.
Okay.
Okay? Mm. It's difficult to convince me now to become a Muslim.
Yeah.
It's not easy for me to change my faith.
Yeah.
Because I believe in the Christian faith.
Yeah, okay.
So it's the same thing. When you talk about people changing their cultural mentality to come to be coping with this European thing. In fact, I lived in Italy for about 10 years.
Mm.
And if you see the Italian, for example, the Italian recipe for food, it's marvelous. It's so wonderful.
Okay.
They have one of the best chefs in the world.
Yeah.
You see men cooking like professional cooks.
Yeah, that's why they are very slim.
And you really
tiny,
see them eating
small.
Well. Italians eat so well. But in Holland, I don't even know what they have. My in-law, the younger sister to my wife, is married to a Dutch man.
Yeah.
The only thing I've seen him eating, we are very close, is patat and Coca-Cola. That is it.
Really?
I mean, yes. And I asked him, I said, what is the Dutch food? Tell me your food.
Mm.
He said, food, what is food? He said, food is anything you eat and you are not hungry. You know?
Yeah.
I said, no. Don't you have Dutch food?
They have.
But he was not really able to tell me. He said patat is our major food, like staple food in Holland.
Yeah.
You see, we Africans cannot cope with that.
Yes, exactly.
Well, I can assure you that when I lived in Italy, I was more healthy.
Yes.
Because the kind of food you eat is really filled with nutrients and vitamins. Mm-hmm. Because the recipe, they are really wonderful. But here, I don't know a Dutch food. I'm not eating one of them.
Okay, but
one day I went to a restaurant somewhere in this around the central station with my wife. I said, "Let me take you out, madam, and let's go and have a treat outside." I was disappointed coming home. Without eating.
Oh,
I didn't find a place to eat because what it showed to me, little things that are not even meaningful are very expensive. Okay, I said, leave this thing, we are not going to eat.
But Elder, I think the issue of healthy lifestyle is not about us eating Italian food or Dutch food.
No, but
we can still eat our own African food, but then to minimum, isn't it?
And but it's not easy. It's not easy to change the belief thing mentality of a true African man to continue to cope, eat in another way. That is the problem. That's the foundation of the problem.
Yes, you've made that point.
Okay.
Noted. So, are you saying that from what you are just saying, I can understand that the African man is so difficult to adjust. African man believe in chauvinism. So even if the wife,
I don't buy that chauvinism.
If the wife is trying to let him know that this type of food is not good enough for you, the African man say what to have his way.
No, but even the ladies, eat like we do. Even our sisters, our wives, eat like the true African woman. They don't believe in all that. You see, I believe in the consumption habit we have.
Exactly.
It has a lot to do with our health.
That's it.
Okay.
That's it.
We live in a different environment.
Yes, and that's it. Consuming so big.
I was telling him to change a particular thing. Each time I go to Bishop's house, he tells me, "Look, Elder, we must eat at our age to keep our health better."
Yes, it's true.
You know, sometimes I eat with him in his house, and I really feel better. I really feel I'm eating differently from what I do every day.
He gave you small.
Okay, but I cannot do that with him every day. Okay, so what I know, the foundation for a healthy lifestyle.
Bishop, the day I will come to your house with my husband, I want to really eat enough.
Attend to this challenge of beginning to have a healthier lifestyle starts from changing that orientation.
It's important.
Yeah. Okay, I told a friend, I said, the way you are really eating, when I saw him eat the meat, he packed on the plate.
Hey,
I said, this guy is weighing 115 kilos. You know?
Hey.
He lives in Germany. And he said, no. This is what we eat. We are Africans.
He's destroying himself.
We eat. You know, so what I'm trying to say is that we need to start changing that orientation. He told me my father and my grandfather ate like this, and my grandfather lived up to 105 years before he died. He was always eating. My own father died at the age of 99. He was always eating and smoking and drinking everything, He didn't die. Why should I die? He's the same generation. We don't die easily like that. You know, we eat. Whatever is consumable, we eat. Okay? So we need to start changing that orientation.
All right.
Particularly when we live in Europe.
Okay,
yes.
Thank you. Yes, you want to say something.
The contribution I want to make is that we are saying that our mentality, we have to change. Yeah, because our food contains a lot of carbohydrate. So, and we like a lot of meat and oily food, and which is hurt, and we know that that is causing the problem. So one thing is, you know that you use half bottle of cooking oil or sunflower oil for your stew, you can make it a quarter.
Yeah.
Later, then gradually you are changing it slowly. Then maybe till it comes to one or two spoonful of oil that you use in for your stew. Because my grandmother was 130 years old before she passed away.
Mm-hmm.
And what I learned from her is she doesn't use oil for her stews.
Wow.
Yeah.
Your grandmother?
Yeah.
She lived in Europe?
No, in Africa.
Wow.
Yeah.
You see, she was only wise.
She was 130 years old. So I was telling Pearl about it, that she doesn't use oil. The oil she will use palm kernel oil or coconut oil.
Hmm.
And really? Now, so I was telling her that, look, back home in the olden days, we use coconut oil and palm kernel oil. Those are the real oils that we use. And mostly even the palm oil, we don't use as much more like the coconut oil. Mm-hmm. But they have changed it that to the molding, this thing that fried or this saturated oils that they have brought to us in Africa. And they make it as if the coconut oil and those things are not good for us. But rather, they are the best. And now they themselves have turned to these oils, which are the coconut oil, the kernel oil, and all those things. So me, I've been telling my children that you have to stop eating those things. Come back to the coconut oil because it is the most healthiest
I was just in a course last week, and I'm still going through the course on healthy lifestyle.
Yeah.
And then we brought a doctor who came to talk on this issue. So this coconut oil is one of the oil that was mentioned not being good now.
Yeah.
And also the fat.
Palm oil.
Yeah. Because they're highly saturated.
Yeah.
So, but now you're saying that that's the best.
No,
yeah.
No.
But
these
research is not saying that it's not the best thing.
Yeah. She mentioned in Africa.
In Africa. But even here now, the coconut oil in the natural shop is more expensive. They are saying that it's the best oil now for us to use than this sunflower and other saturated fats. You know. So, and our own lifestyle too, we eat too heavy. We don't like eating vegetables.
Yeah.
You know, because once I came here, I was sick for some time. They told me I had high blood pressure. Even the day of my book, my pressure was almost 300 over 200.
Wow.
Yeah.
Really?
And so it was God who saved me. And so they put me on medication for so long. But later on, I realized that the medication leaves, I think, they have money. So I decided to change my food. So I changed my eating habit.
Yes.
So every day, Paul encourages me that
That's good.
Because I take the medication, I feel rather more headache than ever.
Yeah.
So I change my everything, my food. I eat the fufu, but I know that in the afternoon, if I'm at home in the afternoon, I eat my fufu, not as big as before.
Mm.
You eat something small, but I take a lot of vegetables, a lot of fruits. So I force myself to buy juicer. I juice, I do everything. I walk, I do my own exercises. I don't go to the gym, but I do my own things at home. I go out and walk a lot.
Let's hear from the professional. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
So what it's, I want to actually to add up to what you said. Firstly, we have to acknowledge that we want to have a new lifestyle.
Yeah.
And then once we acknowledge it and we do it, then it's the next step.
Yeah.
What should I do? Like how to change it?
Yeah.
And that's where we learn to educate. When it comes to food, there are four important aspects in general. What do I eat? So what kind of product?
Yeah.
What kind of oil? What kind of vegetables?
Yeah.
So that's the what do I eat. Then how much do I eat of it?
Yeah.
Maybe it's healthy, but too much of something, like for example the fufu or the yam, when you eat too much, it's also not
good,
not healthy.
Yeah.
It's true.
Then it's how do I prepare it?
Yeah.
And also important, when do I eat?
When do I eat, yes.
So when you know what to eat, how much to eat, and how to eat, then when do I eat? What time of the day is good to eat? Because, of course, if you're in the African culture,
We
used to eat late in the evening and heavy food.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Why? Because
may God be merciful. That's why many of them sleep and die.
Yeah. Yeah, but if we divide the food during the day in that portion that you eat at night in smaller portions during the day, then you feel less heavy in the night and less hungry to eat so much heavy food.
Yeah.
But that's a step we have to take bit by bit. And the most important is why we eat.
Yeah.
Awesome.
To summarize.
Yeah.
Wow. This is so beautiful.
Yeah.
So if you are watching us out there, please just feel free to give us a call on the studio line. It's 020-337-4160. Should you be watching us outside in the lands, please remember to add 0031, then 20337414.
160, we are discussing on the migrants' perspective of a healthy lifestyle. So, ladies and gentlemen, I think we are really dealing with this topic in the way it should be, and I believe that a lot has come out in this discussion. But I would like to know, these challenges that we are facing here, is there any way to a layperson that is watching us, is there any way that that will be easier to help them, you know, step into observing healthy lifestyle? The simplest way, the simplest way. Because probably somebody doesn't really have the time to go to the gym. You know, I can understand. So many things are playing out here. Also, the poverty syndrome is also another thing. Because some may say, okay, I am overworking myself. That's why I come back late and then I eat late. Some are having two jobs. And then we also heard about those who are mentally disturbed because they have sold everything in Africa, came here to come and meet embarrassment. Now they are not in the diaspora, having high blood pressure, having depression, and at the same time, undocumented. Undocumented. Because they cannot find a job. Do you understand? So all of these things are playing out in the lives of the people. But in view of all of this, how can we still advise them to have a healthy lifestyle? As a professional, what do you think would be the easiest? I mean, somebody can close the eyes and say, okay, healthy lifestyle, these are the things needed. I want to start tomorrow. I want to just start tomorrow.
Yeah. When you acknowledge it and you have to start versus the goal, what do I want to reach? Because healthy lifestyle is a big issue. Say, what is my first goal? I want to be healthy in 5 years. Usually you can go to the doctor. He can give you the primary advice where to go to. And even it's very important to know, even for the undocumented in Holland, there are a lot of organizations that can help. For example, for medical, you have the Doctors of the World.
Yeah.
They're also here in Southeast. They help a lot and they can help you where to go to. But that's the trust that you need for, or the community leader, of course, but also that they can help and work together with the professionals that can always help you, because Holland is a really good country that helps you with everything. You just need to know where to go to. And sometimes you can do it with yourself, but sometimes if you feel, I want it, but I don't know how to, always go to somebody who can help you, direct you to the right help.
Exactly, exactly.
On the community part, I am a community leader, and I understand the problems of my people. First, I look to the TV and I tell everyone under the sound of my voice that if we intend to come to Europe, decide what are you going to do in Europe. Don't be fooled about this migration thing. Don't take dangerous routes of crossing oceans and rivers because you think Europe is pitted with gold.
Mm-hmm.
It is a fallacy, it is wrong, and I debunked it and I say, don't do it. But if you find yourself here already, I'm not here to judge anybody.
Yeah.
It is important that you look for a community for you to belong to. They said a tree can never make a forest.
It's true.
So you need someone to talk to. Yeah. You need someone to guide you. From whatever community, if you are from the East Africa, look for an East African community and belong to them. If you are from the Western part, look for your people. They will be able to guide you on what to do and not what to do.
Mm-hmm.
I had a friend who was in this country, and at a day he went to the hospital, the doctor told him, you had less than a week to slump and die.
Hmm. Really?
He stayed in this part of the world for 13 years, undocumented, he had no paper. He had to go home out of frustration.
Oh.
But he went home a sick man.
Jesus.
Yeah. Because the problems of here weighed on him,
mm-hmm.
his high blood pressure was running out of control, and was on medication, was going to AMC and all that. The summary is this. Join an association, a community that will help you. Your people will always run to you. Don't say, don't mind them. I did not come to Europe to join an association. I came here to make my life better. If you stay in your house, you will just die. Get out of that place, look for a community that belongs to you. You can speak your language and they will understand your problem and they'll be able to guide you right.
So the guide, eventually, did he die?
No, he was treated and he has gone back home to Nigeria.
Oh.
He's gone back home to Nigeria and I hope he's getting better. And there are so many things, misconceptions out there in Africa. Mm-hmm. And you still see on the television our people are dying in the Mediterranean Sea, in Sahara Desert, crossing Libya, dangerous mm-hmm. place that is war torn, all in an attempt to come to Europe.
Mm-hmm.
I'm speaking to you as a community leader, and under the sound of my voice, I tell you, don't do it. Look for something to do in Africa. If you can go to school, go to school. If you can learn a trade, learn a trade. The street of Europe is not painted in gold and diamond. Mm-hmm. Don't let people deceive you.
Thank you so much. That's a very good one. Wow.
Well, in my personal contribution to this, I think, like I will always emphasize over and over again, we have a problem that is not easy to resolve. Like my sisters mentioned earlier, you see, it's not about what we eat, how we eat it, when to eat it, how we prepare it. That is the only challenge to our health problems. The mental, the psychological, the emotional. I can assure you that, to the best of my knowledge, more Nigerians, when you talk about the emotional breakdown that can destroy one's health, all right? We have more problems, for example, in marriages here in Europe than when we were back home.
Really?
Yes. Okay? And it's a
Are you talking about?
It's a complicated issue.
You made mention of this 2 weeks ago,
right?
Then we have to talk about it.
It's a complicated issue. It's a wide, complicated issue that we take for granted. You see, our attitude in marriage here is so different. Many times we are forced to adjust to certain kind of situation that we will not adjust to if we were in Africa. Okay? And so, like a friend was telling me the other time, the wife had something, for example, she had the thing and she was not patient enough to confirm. She came and pounced on this man and drove him out of the house.
Oh!
Okay? He went to McDonald's to sleep. The police came there and they kicked him out and said, "You are staying too long here." And the guy became frustrated.
Yeah.
Okay, I met him in a barbering salon. He was telling me his story. It was terrible. If you see him, you know that he's broken down so emotionally. Yeah. He said, "Even what my wife accused me of, I didn't do it. It just gossip here and there." Okay, but that would not happen in Africa. It's not possible. Okay, so we have emotional problems.
You should join a community.
Okay.
When you have problems like that, if you are from a Edo state in Nigeria, or you are Tanzania or Ugandan, you should be able to, when you have problems of this nature, you call the leaders of this community. This is what I'm going through. Like
exactly.
I said, a tree can never make a forest.
Exactly.
So if we are deviating to marital issue, it's a different topic.
No, we are talking about, we are linking it to, you see,
healthy lifestyle.
We are linking it to,
because it's all right, isn't it?
You see, I'm sorry, my sister. An emotionally broken down man or woman
can never be healthy. No.
I can assure you that you don't sleep well.
It's true.
You don't sleep. It's terrible.
Well, there is
it's
no,
better than
no,
be hungry.
That there is no smoke without fire.
Okay.
So you only had one side of a story, and I've often said there is only two sides to a coin.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
Let's face the fire. There is only two sides to a coin. I don't apportion blame whether the woman is right or wrong.
No.
The bottom line remains, if you are having psychological issues, marital issues,
belong to a group,
a community that you can share with, either
your
with
bedroom.
Your pastor of your church, or if you are a Muslim, the imam of your mosque, if you are a Buddhist or Hindu, whatever you believe, join a community where you can. Look, God did not create man alone. He created man and said, it's not good for a man to
be stay alone.
But I will bring a helpmate.
Uh-huh. And when the helpmate
becomes a problem,
when the helpmate is not allowed to function as a helpmate, then that's when the problem comes in. And the helpmate also have to know that God said you are a helpmate. He didn't say you must come and become the boss. You are to be a helpmate. So you must be a helpmate. It doesn't matter the environment you find yourself.
But
like myself, I'm a very helpmate to my honorable husband. He can testify that. So when people talk about people who have a healthy marriage, that's why I'm a marriage consultant anyway.
Yeah.
So you see, it's very important to have a healthy. I'm proud of my marriage. I talk about it. You don't know how long I've already married.
Yeah.
So. But I'm also in Europe. Why is it that whatever is happening in Europe is not affecting me? It's because I put God as my number one.
Yes.
Okay. When you put God as your number one, He will select his own son for you. Yes. Some people rushed into marriage when it is not supposed to be. So yeah. They went and they grabbed
someone
their own perfect, their own, what do you call it?
Imaginary
They didn't take perfect, God's perfect will. Yeah. God's perfect will. What they took is permissive. Because they took the man, they went and they began to pray. Give me this man as my husband. Mm-hmm. So when you worry God so much, then he give it permissive will.
They marry someone as spouse.
Okay, they marry somebody's as spouse. When their own is at the corner. Yeah. So that could be what happened. But at the same time, I will not blame your friend or the guy you are talking about. Because this lady who yielded herself to gossip should have been a little bit sympathetic to know. You don't need to drive another person's son out that way. Because if somebody would drive your own son that way, that wouldn't be nice. All right, this is where I want to end by now. Let's hear other people. Yes.
No, just a minute, madam. So let's go there. Emotionally, we need to consider how we maintain our emotional life as it relates to our health. We need to be able to determine the kind of social life we live. Okay, it's not about just the food we eat, it's about the social life we live.
That's also
many of us drink too much alcohol.
They enter the bottle.
Okay.
Or did they see made in China, they don't stop.
You know. And then others have social problems. If you know, I sometimes I describe Europe as an open prison. You know, where everything you do is guided by a law. It's you just have to obey. Otherwise you get into trouble.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and the Europe life is also very expensive. Mm-hmm. Okay, and you earn a salary. You see, all these things affect our health. Okay, when you earn a salary of maybe 1,500 euros and your rent is already 900 euros, then when you pay your rent out of 1,005, then you pay bills.
Nobody forced you to go and live there. You chose.
So we have these problems to tackle with when it comes to dealing with our health.
It's true.
Okay, there are too many things that affect our health, but we can manage to try to cope, not to live above our income, not to buy too many clothes we cannot pay for, not to eat the kind of too much delicious food
that
we cannot afford
that
on a daily basis.
That's cheap.
Or go and buy the one that are too cheap. These things affect our health. Thank you.
Yes. Thank you so much. Yes, quickly.
I would like to come in here. What I can see actually is that we need to make a choice for our own lives. Mm-hmm. And also the choice that we want a healthy lifestyle.
Yes.
And you have to own it. Because nobody can do it for you. You cannot sit down and then be pointing fingers. There is, everything is possible.
Yes.
But not everything is good for us to do. And God is always on our side, but we also have to do our part. We cannot sit down and just hoping for the manna to drop down. It will never come down.
It doesn't drop anymore.
We are already blessed, but we have to own it. And if the community leaders will help, and also the professionals on this will also help us. And in this case, you go out and be bold also. Let the people know that, listen, it's not to tell you are not living well, but this thing is not good for you. Try it this or try it that.
Exactly.
And we all come together. And also in our churches.
Every
our,
pastor has
every,
to
every
put
path.
It in their curriculum to know that at least every once in a month, talk about healthy lifestyle so that your people can know what it is.
Yes.
Do you understand?
Yes.
I think that is very important.
In my community last year, I called a medical doctor and a dietitian who gave us lectures.
Okay.
And for me, as an individual, I had calls to see my doctor about 5 years ago, six years ago.
Mm-hmm.
And every year, I do annual medical checkup.
Okay.
You see, we have certain ideas in our head we need to expunge.
Mm-hmm.
Say, black man strong.
Strong.
Black man no strong nothing.
At all. Which guy is strong?
And that is the fact. Oh, not if they keep black man. It's a myth.
I can't believe they are speaking that way.
Every year, I go for medical checkup, give them my urine, my blood, my day, they take it. 5 years ago or six, my doctor told me, look, like your sugar level is a little bit, it's not getting there, but it's getting a little bit too high. I said, what do I do? He said, change my eating habit. That was when I changed.
Mm.
When he came to my house, he was shocked. Yes. And the dietitian told me I should stop eating white bread. I don't want to mention certain bread names so that I don't demarcate some people's bread. There are some bread that is all full of sugar.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
That's
like,
so,
yes.
I don't want to mention the name.
The sugary part. We know already.
Ghana bread.
I don't know.
I don't, please, so.
I'm not mentioning
it's not only Ghana
name.
Bread.
There are some bread.
I can get bread too.
It's all sugar and nothing else and flour. So the doctor told me, or the dietitian told me, I should go to the Abatina, wherever I buy my bread, and look at brown bread that wrote Volcarum.
Yeah,
exactly. Yeah,
focus. That, yes, that's
what I take. Yeah. That is what I eat. If you come now, he knows.
Whole wheat.
I put a little bit, I make sure that's what I eat, put tomatoes, put lettuce, put garbage. Yeah. It's rich. When
very,
I bite
very.
It, they say, wow.
That's why it's so filling, eh? It's so filling.
Yeah.
Hey,
this is
sick.
You're
yeah.
making me remember to want to go.
These are facts.
You're reaching me. You're reaching me.
I this morning. These are facts. That, listen, what I eat, just two slices of that wheat bread, what I get from it, the vitamin and the nutrients, is far better than if I eat a bowl of a bar and a yam.
Hey,
or
with a goosey soup and cow leg.
That is why most Africans will say when they eat that bako and they go to your toilet, they'll be there for 1 hour. They will flush, they will wait again, they will flush the second time they are waiting for 1 hour.
It's unflushable.
Because the only thing they do, your toilet is
full. Push it down.
So
like Timba.
Let's get knowledge.
Oh my God! Well, for the second time, please. So, no, who wants to just add 1 minute because
before
we have to round up now,
the professional.
Yeah.
I will speak on what she said. It all starts with acknowledging your problems.
Yes.
You know, you have overweight. You have to admit it. Yes, I have a problem. And what is the next step to do towards it? And as she said, trust is very, very important.
Yeah.
We should trust in the professionals. You know, when you go to the doctor tells you, do this, do that, as as Bishop said, it is very important to follow all these regulations and not just for a short term, but for the rest of your life, because it is all about your life. And the other thing is that, try also and find a social place where you go to, you know?
Yes.
Like,
and socialize.
Yeah, and socialize with other people or go to the gym, you know? Just go there. You don't need to work out 2 hours, but just go and look at how people are doing. 30 minutes to 45 minutes. It's okay, they say.
Take a walk within your area.
Yeah, or take a walk within your area.
Yes.
And then things will be all right.
Okay, yeah. Thank you so much. Yes. No, it's okay. She can speak.
Yeah. And what I want to add up is, as all my brothers and sisters said, there are a lot of churches in South Osea. Mm. There are a lot of our local unions too are there. So we can join any of them.
Yeah.
So that we can associate ourselves with people. We talk, we have fun. There are a lot of, most of the time, there are a lot of parties and other things there. Not that you become a party bed, but once a while, you go out and refresh.
It's important. It's important.
Yeah, you refresh yourself.
It's important.
You talk with people.
Yeah.
Have fun. And let us overcome the depression and the stress in our life, because the stress brings a lot of sicknesses in us.
Right.
So let us have that peace. Or if you are a Christian, let us take the word of God to be our walking sticks. Because when you have that negative mind, or things are coming into your mind, that brings the depression and the stress. So the moment the negative things are coming, you stand on the word of God and rebuke it. And be declaring the word of God upon your life, you see that everything will change completely. That depression, that stress, everything. The Bible said there is nothing impossible for God to do.
It's true.
With God, all things are possible.
Yeah.
Whether you are documented or undocumented, even those people, a lot of people are there undocumented, they can go to anywhere they want.
No one is illegal in the world.
God has created the heaven and the earth for all of us.
Yes.
So let us have that free mind, that free heart to go to anywhere we want to go.
Assistance.
But go well. Don't go and misbehave. Don't do what they ask you not to do. And you see that you'll be free. But if you go against the law will come against you.
Thank you so much. Yes.
Yes. So, actually, I summarized it already, but I want again to say I agree with you, and I'm really appreciated that your trust in the professionals become more and more.
Yeah.
But it's also important to know that our trust as professionals in the community leaders and work together with them and be together with you all it's like a blessing to be here.
Yes, thank you so much. Thank you so much. I believe this whole broadcast have been well said, and those who have heard us, I believe they have also learned something. So those also who go to church, I believe that the spiritual leaders like me must be able to also draw their curriculum to cover this aspect of our health, and at the same time not to be over religious, you know, because sometimes we just stay in the church activity and then there is no social content. The people must also enjoy the social content of whatever we are offering. Don't forget, Jesus also was going to parties. He went to parties. He ate with the sinners. We don't need to spiritualize everything. Every second we spiritualize everything, and the people don't even have any social moment. Please, let's not spiritualize all of these things. Allow the people to go out, mix up with their mates, mix up with you know, some of them also are trapped into singleness because they are thinking on how they're going to get married, where they're going to get their partners. Their partners may not be in the church, and we just want to pay them to. Meanwhile, there are no men there who would marry them. So please allow them as well, because these things, if their mind is not...
But your pastor tells you, don't go yoke with the unbelievers. Then what do you do?
That's why Mama is saying that we should not be over spiritual.
That one is a different topic for another.
Yeah, we should, to have a healthy lifestyle, we must also allow our people to know that they are social beings, you know. The spiritual content is good. I'm speaking, I've pastored for 22 years, so I know what I'm talking about. So the spiritual content is good, but allow them as well to have, I mean, a life of their own. Do you understand? You allow them to have at least life of their own. When they go out once in a while to a friend's party, I don't think that is sinful, because this person already knows that, okay, I don't want to go and take alcohol. I don't want to. But let them just go. Allow them to go. We don't need to put some kind of blaming attitude and make it seem as if every party they go, they have committed sin. You know, social network is important for a healthy lifestyle. You must have a healthy social. As a matter of fact, there was a network I belonged before. This network was draining me. Each time I finish with this network, I only become more sorrowful. I told my husband, no, this is not good for me, because it's not a healthy lifestyle for me. You know, I enter a network that would be draining me. That wouldn't be nice. Before you know it, it will begin to give me some signs of what I don't want to have in my body. So I had to just cut it off. So I advise us, having listened to all of this and many more, gentlemen and ladies, I believe that there's a lot to speak about. So we can impact our migrant community through this network. Because when we begin to speak what we have spoken today, many will hear. Because there are so many who didn't know before, but now they are going to hear. Because after this, now this broadcast will go to Salto. Everybody will hear. Amen? So from time to time, please, I advise that when we stretch forth our hand and call you, please come. If you can bring somebody else, bring. Let's begin to talk about it. Let's make noise about healthy lifestyle. Before you know it, it penetrates everywhere.
Your relation begins to change.
Exactly. God richly bless every one of you. Shelly, I just want to say God bless you so much.
Amen. You all too.
Thank you so much for being here. Yeah. Thank you all of you for being here. So those who have listened to us, God also bless you. And on behalf of every one of us, can we say bye to our audience?
Bye.
We love you and stay blessed. Tune in again and join us next time to talk about healthy lifestyle, marital aspect of it.
Amen.
God bless you.